Hello students, today I am taking up this session for class 9th and my topic is rationalization. Now what is rationalization? Rationalization means that we have some irrational numbers and we have to make them rational. So there are some basic rules. As we have in laws of exponents, similar kind of some rules apply here. So let's go through the rules one by one and we need to apply them. If we have under root of a square, then since both of these are inverse operations, square root of a and square of a, so they will, these two functions will cancel each other and we get a. Similarly, if we have to multiply two irrational numbers, then we can take the product of numbers and put them under the root. Similar thing for the division. Now if we have irrationals in addition form and same in subtraction form, then the formula identity of a plus b and a minus b applies, which means it will be under root a square minus under root b square. So the squares and roots will cancel and it will become a minus b. Similarly here, if one number is rational, one is irrational, after multiplying, since this will be again a plus b, a minus b will be applied, so it will be a square minus b square. So this will be a square, the rational part, and irrational part, the root will disappear and it will become b. Similarly here, a plus b whole square identity will be applied, the square and square roots get cancelled and rest will remain as it is. If a positive is here, then this will also be positive. If there is one minus sign here, this will be minus. Now if we have completely four rational numbers, two binomials are multiplied with each other, then every number is to be multiplied in the usual way. This will be multiplied to this and this, then this will be multiplied to this and this, and all the numbers separately will remain inside the root. Now suppose we have two, I am taking one example. I have 4 plus root 7 and this is to be multiplied with 3 plus root 2. Then one part is rational, one part is irrational, so it is like this. So first 4 is multiplied to both, then this will be multiplied to both. So it becomes 12 plus 4 root 2 plus 3 root 7 plus root 14. Right? Now nothing is common here. So this is the answer. Second example I am taking, where we have a rational number and in the denominator we have an irrational part. Now to rationalize this, rationalizing will mean rationalizing the denominator. So for that we need to multiply it with, we will change the sign of this and divide and multiply with this number. The purpose of doing it is, we get in the denominator a plus b into a minus b form, which will become a square minus b square. Finally, so the irrational part will remain in the numerator, but it will not remain in the denominator. That's why it is also called rationalizing the denominator. So this will become 2 minus root 3 and here it will be a plus b into a minus b, so a square minus b square, so it becomes 2 square minus root 3 square. So in the numerator it will remain as 2 minus root 3. Here it will become 4 minus this and this get cancelled, so it is 3. So it comes out to be 2 minus root 3 upon 1, or we can write it as 2 minus root 3. So this is the answer. Another example I am taking, where we don't have a binomial but just a simple monomial. If there is a 2 upon root 7 and we have to rationalize it, then we will just multiply it with root 7 by root 7, so that this becomes square and the square root gets cancelled. So this will be 2 root 7 upon, here it is root 7 square, so this get cancelled and we will get 2 root 7 upon 7. So this is 2 upon 7 root 7. This is the answer. Similarly, if I have 2 root 7 upon root 11, then also I will only rationalize the denominator. this will become 2 root 77 upon 11, and that will become the answer. We can write it as 2 upon 11, the rational part and irrational parts separately. So this is how we do the rationalization. Thank you.